Student, welcome to our physics discussion, that is physics in a smart way. We were with calculus, and in continuing to do so, we'll be progressing in the topic. Now the time has gone to feed you around, say, 20 formulas which you have to cram up. If you manage to tackle with calculus, at least the issues will be facing in physics. Those things will be taught to you in a more organized way during your study of class 12 mathematics, but physics cannot wait up to that time. Starting in the first month, you'll be encountering the topics or the issues in physics which require idea of calculus. Thing is that, as I told you, we shall be taking up around 20 formulas which you have to cram up, which you have to mock up. But thing is that goes against the spirit of physics. If you do not know the logic or the idea, then cramming up will be giving you no benefit. Basically, first you'll be wondering where from the formula comes up. How do I know that will be correct or not? Because the teacher has given me or those formulas are there in the book. That means I have to follow it blindly. That is strictly against the spirit of physics. And we know, whenever we are going for more knowledge, it is said our wise men in the past, they have told in our scriptures or anywhere in India or elsewhere, that knowledge should give you freedom, and more knowledge should be giving us more freedom. More knowledge should be not in the way that we will be stuffing our brain with more number of formulas. All those are jumbled up, and sometimes there is no head or tail to it. So thereby, my basic aim here is to take up some formulas in calculus and directly trying to establish them, and then you see that they are correct, they work, and they work well. Of course, the issue here with me is that I cannot go for testing up all those formulas. That take a hell lot of time. But first of all, there must be a belief inside you that those set of formulas are correct, because one or two formulas you have tested in the set and they came out to be true. They came out to be perfect. That is the basic motto of this video, and maybe the video which will be coming just after it. So we have taken the derivative again, because every one of you know calculus consists of two parts. First is differentiation, second is integration, and differentiation has got another name, that is derivative. Okay. We try to consider a term in mathematics that is known as mathematical function. A mathematical function is a very big thing in mathematics that is taught to you, that is there at your level 11th and 12th. But somehow the people in mathematics, they present it in a very intricate way. It has got many faces, it has got many tails, it has got many hearts, it has got many livers, and all those things. Of course, those are for fun, but we got no time to discuss all those things. I try to stuff in the idea of function into your head in a very straight way, that So let us consider two variables, one is y, other is x. Starting with your school level, you know the variable quantities, they are presented by our English letters like y, x, p, q, r, s, like that. They are variables. I may take x as the market price of potato, and you know every day that has got a serious chance of changing. You may take y as the price of petrol or diesel that you put in our bikes and all that, and you know that is going through a change almost every week. So by that we mean a variable. Or what does a variable mean? We know it, you know? We are not fools. But I have taken two variables, one is y, other is x. X I am branding as independent variable. And y is a dependent variable It is dependent variable because y depends on x. X doesn't depend upon y. Y depends upon x. And mathematically, the people in mathematics, our math teacher and mathematicians books, they present it in with a peculiar sign. Y is a function of x. They write it like this, y f of x. That doesn't mean anything else except that there are two variables, one is y, other is x, and when somebody says y equal to f of x, sometimes f of x, if you write f of x so many times and a new function comes in a new style, so then you can write gx, doesn't matter, these symbols f and g, they show that there are two variables, one is y, other is x. X is independent, x doesn't depend upon y. That may depend upon so many other things, we don't consider that here. But y is heavily dependent on x. So thereby said, they say y is a function of x. As an example, I may put y equal to x square. That is a very simple example against y as a function of x. You know clearly as x goes on changing, the value of y will be corresponding changes. Okay, of course, you may make it otherwise, x equal to root over of y, but for the time being, we do not think of that. We simply dwell upon the idea that y equal to x square, okay? So that is an example of mathematical function where y is a dependent variable and x is independent variable. We may put it in so many ways. Y equal to, let us say, that is x square or x cube plus sin x plus something x. You know, here also the same thing is valid. X is independent, but when the value of x changes, then value of y changes. Okay. In derivative, there is a term known as dy by dx. That is usually referred to as, that is differentiation or derivative in words. If I express it, derivative of y with respect to x. You may be wondering, are bhai ye kya aa gaya? 2x, that is the style of the derivative. And from this term, you may not comprehend everything else, but at least you do know that dy refers to a very small change in y, and you are dividing it with a very small change in x. That is the basic meaning of dy by dx. That is known as derivative of y with respect to x. Of course, as we go on in our study of mathematics and physics or sciences, this dy by dx will be revealing in new and different lights. but we won't go to that at present. So dy by dx basically for us is the division of two quantities. Those are very small. Those are very small. And the numerator contains a very small change in y, and the denominator contains a very small change in x. And the very small change in y is dependent upon the very small change in x, because we know the basic statement is y is a function of x. Because the x is changing, then due to that y is changing. So here dy is dependent upon dx. Some of you might be wondering that, of course, that what this thing will lead to us. That will be a very small quantity. But mind it, a very small quantity divided by another very small quantity may not be insignificantly small. If I divide a very small quantity like 10 to the power minus 9 by another very small quantity, that is 10 to the power minus 10, the result is directly equal to 10. So a very small quantity divided by another small quantity can lead to a significant result. So here, dy by dx also will be giving you beautiful values that should not be taken as very insignificant thing that is meaningful, and that will be helping you in many ways in your study of science. Okay. So now, this is known as the derivative of y with respect to x. Okay, now we try to work it out. We see how this behaves and what values that gives us. We consider the same our old functions that we have already discussed. Let y equal to x square. So once you consider y equal to x square, if you try to take the value of dy by dx, we know that will be giving us d. In place of y, I can replace it nicely with x square by dx. Our formula set, which I am to give you, just like I told you, a set of around formulas, some formulas involving derivative or differentiation, some other formulas involving your integration. That formula set says derivative of x square with respect to x or dx will be giving you 2x. That is the rule. But here our job is how that comes out. I am using fundamental principles because so far as the knowledge of mathematics that we got is the school level knowledge. And at the school level, you are not trained in calculus. So if I use some esoteric formulas and all those things, you may not believe it. And if you cannot believe it, then there is a doubt in our brain whether the formula is correct, or more fundamentally, where from the formula comes up, I don't know. The thing is like this. Now, let us say we try to solve it using our school level ideas. Already you do know that we have considered that y is a function of x. We have assumed that y equal to x square, that is the basic function. So because y equal to x square, here we proceed like this. We allow x to change. the initial value of x was x. If I allow x to change in a very minute way, and you know those minute changes, the minute increments or decrements, we can go for decreasing the x also. That will be giving us the same result. But increasing is always a vector that induces a positive feeling us. X increases by a small amount dx, we assume. So initial value of x is x. After an increase of dx, we know the same x becomes x plus dx. And when x transforms itself from x to x plus dx, we know y also will be changing. Automatically, our common sense says y will become y plus dy because x is increasing. That will be equal to x plus dx squared. Are you getting me or not? When x is changing, we know y is changing. X is changing by a very small amount. Automatically, our expectation will be that y will be changing by a small amount also. So when x is x, y is y. When x becomes x plus dx, automatically our common sense says y must have made itself into y plus dy. And if we expand it, that is just a plus b whole square, that becomes x square plus 2x into dx plus dx square. Three terms come up. One is x square, second is a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now look at the terms more neatly. One is x squared, it's okay. Second is 2 into x into dx, that's okay. The third term is dx square. We take the third term, we try to focus on the third term in a more detailed way. dx square, what does it mean? That is dx into dx, dx square. That will be equal to dx into dx. But already you know dx is an extremely small quantity. When two extremely small quantities, they are multiplied, result, you know yourself, they will be yielding a quantity which is still very, very small compared to them also. Say dx equal to 10 to the power minus 9. I'm multiplying with 10 to the minus 9. Then that yields me, that gives me a so small quantity, that is 10 to the minus 18. It is so small, it is very, very small compared to the quantities itself, which are already very, very small. In mathematics, physics, when somebody tries to define physics, you might have seen in your books, that physics is a science of approximate measurement. Physics is basically a science of approximate measurement. As you go on learning the things, you'll be learning that there are many things, many physical quantities, which cannot be exactly measured, which cannot be exactly measured. We can find a near about value and we have to be satisfied with that. And great men like Albert Einstein and all those, they have put their stamps on it. They have emphasized that you human beings, you live in a relative world. Don't try to go for absolute things, absolute measurements, because God has made you. If at all a God exists or not, I do not know. You also do not know. You might have been knowing because you are kids. So the world is such that absolute value and all those things, sometimes they are futile exercise. You may go for a near about value. And if a quantity, my basic point, my emphasis is that if a quantity is very, 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 very small, if you neglect it, if you drop it from your calculation, that doesn't put such a harm in your final answer. So similarly, dx is a term which is minute, very small, that is almost nearly equal to zero. It approaches zero. So the square or cube, whatever you get of dx, they are so small, they can be neglected. And calculus depends on that. And mathematics gives us special permission to neglect that also. That is completely approved by mathematics. Okay. So here, one thing that I told you, that we may not be able to find out the exact value. Say, I ask you, you and me are meeting directly face to face. So we assume that I ask you of your age. Then you say, sir, 15 years, 16 years, or 17 months. I again ask you, how many years? You say 15, 16, or 17. Then I ask, how many months? You say 5 months, 6 months, 3 months, or like that. Then I ask you, how many days? You also can answer it comfortably. Then I ask you, how many hours on that particular day you are born? Then you can be able to answer it. If I ask you how many minutes, you know, on that hour, if somebody says I was born on this year, on this day at 10:30 a.m., then I ask you 10:30, of course, you are answering in minutes. If I ask you how many seconds, then you'll be starting to falter. Okay? Because you didn't record it when you were born. Somebody else, maybe your parents or some family member, they record it. May is not a proper word. Mostly the chance is that they have not recorded. They record up to the level of minutes, not seconds. Even if somebody have recorded it, then I come down to a still summer screen. How many milliseconds? How many microseconds? All those things, we know those cannot be answered. So thereby we try to establish that you cannot find out your exact time of birth. But does it hamper us in any way? No, we live in this world very nicely. We study, we eat, we play, we do everything. That is my basic point. Similarly, if I ask you, what is the exact length of the scale that you got in your carry bag or in your school bag, you can't be able to answer. If I stress upon the word exact, that will be around 12 inches or some, sorry, 12 centimeters or something like that. But if I ask you how many millimeters, how many micrometers, how many picometers, you can't be able to answer. Okay? But that doesn't prevent you in using your scale, because we are not in our mostly day-to-day jobs, we are not involved with the measurement of length up to some micrometers and picometers. Okay, that was the main point. So the basic thing was that if a quantity becomes too small, we may drop it from our calculation. There we may be able to state that because dx is very small, dx, it approaches zero. So any higher power of dx means dx square or dx cube or dx4, they can be comfortably neglected. Okay, that was my point. So thereby, coming back to our calculation, so y plus dy, that is nearly equal to your, now the last answer is x plus 2x dx. We have dropped the term dx square. Okay. So if that is that, and initially we know y equal to x square, and we know y plus dy equal to x square plus 2x into dx. So if you make a difference from y plus dy, we subtract y on the LHS, you'll be getting y plus dy minus y. That gives you dy only. I am skipping that step. You know it. On the right hand side, we got this thing, x square plus 2x dx. And on the RHS, right hand side of the first equation, that is x square. So when you subtract x square from x square plus 2x dx, that leaves us with a value that is 2x dx. If I bring this dx to the left hand side, then that answers us that dy by dx equal to 2x. And that establishes our formula that we'll be taking up in derivative, that derivative of y with respect to x when y equal to x square, or derivative of x square with respect to dx will be equal to 2x. We established that. Okay, using our ideas, school level ideas, small mathematics that you know. Okay, so that was the issue for today, that is to establish a formula in derivative, and those formulas are correct. I cannot go in establishing all the formulas, because they take time, and your math teachers will be angry with me, because my job is to teach you physics, not mathematics. But for boosting up our confidence, that at least to show that those formulas must be correct, because I have tested one of the formulas in the set and that came out to be correct. So the whole set will be correct. With the faith like that, we have to continue. In my next video, we shall be doing the same thing with integration. We pick up a formula, use our past principles that we have learned our school level and try to establish. Then you can believe in the set of the formulas that will be given. So thank you for your viewing. If you think that helps you, you may go for a like, you may subscribe it and share it among your friends. And thank you again.